John.
Sarah, Rob Porter's first wife, Colby Holden, spoke with the FBI as part of his clearance process on January 25th, 2017, during which she says that she laid out all of the allegations that have since been aired against Rob Porter and provided the FBI with the photographs that were the turning point in his termination last week. At any time between January 25th of last year and last Wednesday, did the FBI make anyone here at the White House, whether it was in the counsel's office, the chief of staff's office, or anyone else, did the FBI make anybody here aware of the allegations that had been raised against Porter by Colby Holderness and his second wife, Jenny Willard?
We learned of the extent of the situation involving Rob Porter last Tuesday evening, and within 24 hours, his resignation had been accepted and announced. We announced a transition was going to happen, and within hours, it did. The president and the entire administration take domestic violence very seriously and believe all allegations need to be investigated thoroughly. Above all, the president supports victims of domestic violence and believes everyone should be treated fairly and with due process. We've addressed this situation extensively, and we have nothing more to add at this time on that topic.
The allegations that were raised against him would make him a prime candidate for blackmail, which would lead any responsible person at the FBI to come to the White House to say, just want to let you know, this person will likely never get a permanent security clearance. Was that concern ever raised to anyone here at the White House?
As I know Raj addressed last week, we let the process play out. It was ongoing, hadn't been completed. And beyond that, in the statement I just gave you, I don't have anything else to add. Cecilia.
Why haven't we heard the president say exactly what you just said right there, that he takes domestic violence very seriously?
I spoke with the president. Those are actually directly his words that he gave me
earlier today. Why hasn't he said that? He had the opportunity.
It's my job to speak on behalf of the president. I spoke to him, and he relayed that message directly to me, and I'm relaying it directly to you.
Does he believe Rob Porter's accusers, or are they lying?
Look, as I just said, the president, along with the entire administration, take domestic violence very seriously and believe all allegations need to be thoroughly investigated. And above all, the president supports the victims of domestic violence and believes everyone should be treated fairly and with due process.
That doesn't answer the question.
As I just said, I'm not going to go beyond that. That's where we are right now. Aisha.
Does the president still wish Rob Porter well? Does he still believe that he wants him to have a great career ahead of him? Because that would seem...
I think the president of the United States hopes that all Americans can be successful in whatever they do. And if they've had any issues in the past, I'm not confirming or denying one way or the other, but if they do, the president wants success for all Americans, and that he was elected to serve all Americans, and he hopes for the best for all American citizens across the country. Jim?
What about the president's tweet over the weekend? People's lives are being shattered and destroyed by a mere allegation. It seems like the president was believing Mr. Porter as opposed to his alleged victims. Why did the president tweet that over the weekend? Why is he seemingly defending Mr. Porter publicly? Is it because he has faced his own allegations? Is there some sensitivity there? Is that why that is?
Look, as I just said, and I'll repeat it again, the president and the entire administration take domestic violence very seriously and believe all allegations need to be investigated thoroughly. He certainly supports the victims of domestic violence above all else and believes that everyone should be treated fairly and with due process.
Is there some
the president simply saying that there should be a due process that should be followed and looked at.
Is there tone deafness there? Is there just a being on the wrong side of things?
I don't think the president being on Friday, supporting due process for any allegation is not tone deaf. I think it is allowing things to be investigated and a mere allegation not be the determining factor. He's not taking a side necessarily one way or the other on any specific issue here. He's talking about mere allegations shouldn't be the determining factor for any individual, that there should be due process. I think anybody here, if they were accused of something, hold on, Jim, I'm not finished. Hold on. Jim, hold on. What I'm saying is I think anybody here, if they were accused of something, would want the opportunity to go through due process. That's all we're saying.
The vice president said he was appalled by the allegations. Why did the president not use this as an opportunity to say something like that? Why does he have to speak through you?
The president has been clear multiple times through myself and others within the administration that we condemn domestic violence in all forms.
He has not said it. Why has he not said it?
I'm the spokesperson for the White House and for the president, and I'm saying it to you right now.
Why does the president have to say it? Why didn't he say it?
I'm not sure how I can be any more clear. I think the president has espoused his views on this, and I certainly have echoed and told them for everyone.
He wishes Porter well, and that he believes that people should have due process, but he hasn't addressed the victims of domestic violence at all.
That's actually not true. If you were paying attention to what I just read to you, you would understand the opposite. He literally dictated that statement to me, and so I'm not really sure how that's not the president speaking on that topic. Matthew?
Two questions, if I may. Does the White House have a rule or policy regarding how long an employee is permitted to operate with an interim security clearance?
As we've said, we're not going to get into the details of how the clearance process works. Last week, we went further than we ever have before due to extenuating circumstances, and there's nothing further to add on that front. Look, this is a process that doesn't operate within the White House. It's handled by our law enforcement and intelligence community, and we support that process. It's the same process that has been used for decades for other and previous administrations, and we're relying on that process at this point. I do think that it's up to those same law enforcement and intelligence agencies to determine if changes need to be made to their process.
Sarah, to follow on that, can you say whether the White House is beginning to examine or review cases of staffers who are operating under an interim clearance?
I can't weigh in.
Examine their cases more closely in light of the Rob Porter situation.
I'm not going to get into the details of the process beyond what we've already said, but I can tell you that we do rely on the same process that has been used for decades, and if changes are thought to be made, that would be made by the law enforcement and intel communities that run that process, not the White House. But that's something that could be looked at, certainly in light of this.
Do you have any more information for us on Vanessa Trump? How was the president informed of what happened in New York?
I know the president spoke with her. Beyond that, at this point, it's an ongoing and active investigation, so I can't comment any further. But I can say that the president has spoken with her within the last hour. Jacqueline.
Sarah, I want to just get back to Cecilia's point, which is that the president has a history of defending men who have been accused of sexual assault and harassment and abuse, including Mike Tyson, Bill O'Reilly, Steve Wynn, Corey Lewandowski, Roy Moore, and now Rob Porter. Would the White House like to say today unambiguously that the president believes women making these accusations?
I think the president, like I said, above everything else, supports the victims of any type of domestic violence, but the president also supports due process, and I don't have anything else further to add.
I just want to get back to the timeline, Sarah. So the Intercept reporter, Ryan Grimm, tweeted out photos of Colby Holderness's black eye at 1:53 a.m. on Wednesday, and the Daily Mail published them at 8:30 on Wednesday morning. Then the White House sent CBS a statement at 1:45 on Wednesday afternoon, 12 hours after all of these photos were already published and out. Why was the White House still saying that Porter was a man of integrity and honor after these photos had circulated?
The comments that were made by members of the White House were based on our personal experience, and we could only speak to the interaction that we had personally had.
Sarah, thanks. Why are high-level aides allowed to work with classified information without permanent security clearance?
Once again, that's a question that the FBI and other intelligence communities, they make that determination. That's not something that's decided by the White House. It's the same way that it has been.
Given that you have someone like Rob Porter who didn't have a permanent security clearance.
I missed the first part of your question.
Can you guarantee that you are protecting classified information given that you have someone like Rob Porter who didn't have a permanent security clearance?
I think we're doing and taking every step we can to protect classified information. I mean, frankly, if you guys have such concern with classified information, there's plenty of it that's leaked out of the Hill, that's leaked out of other communities well beyond the White House walls. If you guys have real concerns about leaking out classified information, look around this room. You guys are the ones ones that publish classified information and put national security at risk. That doesn't come from this White House.
Is this White House jeopardizing national security?
We take every precaution possible to protect classified information and certainly to protect national security. It's the president's number one priority is protecting the citizens of this country. It's why we spend every single day doing everything we can to do that. And I think if anyone is publishing or putting out publicly classified information, it's members of the press, not the White House.
Why doesn't Kushner have his permits?
At the end of last week, the White House said that there were things that everyone could have done a better job handling the situation. Have you identified anything specific other than, I know you mentioned law enforcement agencies and the FBI and their process. What about your process? Has the White House identified anything it could have done better in this situation to prevent something like this from happening?
I think we're looking at that internally and agree that there are things we could have done better, and we're going to continue to look at the process and the role we all played and how we can do it better. But not just in this. I think every day we come to work and we hope to do a better job than we did the day before, and we're going to keep doing that every single morning we come to work. We're going to do our best to make this day better than the last and make this country better than the day it was before. That's our goal, and that's what we're going to do in every situation. As we recognized last week, there were some things we could have done better, and we're certainly going to look at every single instance in every single thing we do, how we can always do it a little bit better than we did the day before. Josh?
Sarah, Tuesday night when the initial story came out, White House praises Rob Porter. Wednesday morning, photos come out. White House says this stands by its statement. Wednesday afternoon, the White House continues to praise Rob Porter. And Chief of Staff John Kelly says he acted 40 minutes within knowing the allegations. Can you explain that?
As I said, and I'm going to repeat what I said earlier, that we'd learned of the situation involving Rob Porter last Tuesday evening, and within 24 hours, his resignation had been accepted and announced. We announced a transition was going to happen, and within hours it did. And in terms of timeline, I don't have anything else to add.
Explain that.
I can tell you that a conversation took place within 40 minutes, and beyond that, I really don't have anything else to add, Josh.
We've reported, and others have too, that Don McGahn over, you know, a period of months was told repeatedly by the ex-girlfriend, by the FBI, by, you know, others in the White House about these accusations and didn't do anything. Can you explain why no action was taken by Don McGahn, the chief White House lawyer?
Those allegations that have been reported are not accurate. April.
Sarah, you keep saying the president says we take domestic violence very seriously. Moving forward, how seriously will he take it? What will he do to raise awareness about it, combat against it, particularly as, again, I asked this last week of Raj, as this administration ended the Violence Against Women office, as well as closing down the Women and Girls office, what will be new and different as it relates to combating this?
I believe there's an individual that is in the nomination process to run an office specific to domestic violence. And when we have that process completed, we'll make that personnel announcement, but we are in process of doing that.
I have another question really fast on infrastructure. Infrastructure is about jobs, job creation, and you're talking about rural America. When you're talking about these jobs, are there going to be guidelines as to who can and who won't be hired?
Not that I'm aware of anything to that nature.
Because a lot of the infrastructure projects during the Obama years, when Hilda Solis was Labor Secretary, a lot of those jobs went to Hispanics. And
a lot of those jobs were never completed or started. They were announced, but nothing ever happened on them. We're expecting a very different result to actually announce and complete projects versus just announcing and doing nothing. John.
Thanks a lot, Sarah. I just wanted to get you to clarify something. I think you answered this, but I just wanted to have you clarify it, if you could. It's about the White House counsel, Don McGahn. Are you saying that the White House counsel never learned until last Tuesday that there was any allegation of any sort that was ever leveled against Rob Porter?
Again, I'm not going to go into the specific details of how the process works, but I can say that we learned of the extent of the situation.
Who's we? Because I want to get to Don McGahn specifically.
The White House generally.
Okay. To Don McGahn specifically, though, had he learned at any time before last Tuesday, when this story was broken by the Daily Mail, that there was any allegation of any sort leveled by any person against Rob Porter?
Again, I can't get into the specifics. I can tell you that the process for the background was ongoing, and the White House had not received any specific papers regarding the completion of that background check. So I can't go any further than what we've already said on that front.
John?
Thank you, Sarah. Two brief questions as a follow-up to the last two questions. What is Don McGahn's status as counsel right now?
I think the same as it was 2 weeks ago, 2 months ago, a year ago. He's the head of the White House counsel, and I have no indication to see differently.
All right. And the other question is, Senator Corker said last night he was reconsidering and possibly will reverse his decision not to seek reelection. Already a Republican primary is in process in the state. What's the president's view? Should Senator Corker run again? Would he try to persuade him to, or just let him urge him to go back home to Tennessee?
We haven't had that conversation about Senator Corker's plans, but as always, I can't weigh in on any specifics of the potential of a race, but I would have to talk to the president before making a comment. I'll take one last question, Frank.
Last year, the administration said that the national debt is a crisis, not just for the nation, but for every citizen. Does the president still believe that it is a crisis? And if it is a crisis...
Sorry, I missed the first part. A national what?
A national debt. A national debt. And if the national debt is a crisis, why hit the gas pedal instead of the brake when it comes to spending?
Look, the president, one of the biggest and top priorities of the president's first year in office was to pass the Tax Cuts and Jobs Act, which we think will have a big impact on that moving forward. It's been a major focus on the economy, and the budget today that provides funding for the president's priorities, including national security. The president also knows that one of the most important jobs he has is protecting this country. Therefore, the need for rebuilding our military that had been ignored for so long, infrastructure, focusing on defeating the opioids crisis and a border wall. At the same time, the budget reduces the deficit by over $3 trillion. This budget not only funds the president's priorities, but puts the country on a path to restoring fiscal discipline. I'd encourage you to stick around and talk to Director Mulvaney, who'd be happy to go into more detail on the budget and other things regarding that here in the next bit. Thanks so much, guys.
Sarah, when will he be out here? When will the president come and do a press conference here with us?